Come on, sweet hand with Read the Bones. yeah, I guess that qualifies. I mean, it's got the Read the Bones, and I even have a 2-drop, so I don't have to discard. Opponent going to 6 cards, it looks like. And then yelling Arg, which probably indicates going to 5. Pretty hard to for that not to be the case. Since otherwise, what are you arguing about? And... oh. My opponent did not mean to mulligan, and the client accidentally... the opponent didn't mean to mulligan, lagged and accidentally mulliganed, and had mulled a great hand even. Yeah, that does kind of suck. I'm not sure if opponent's keeping on 6 now, but still, getting forced to mulligan is pretty annoying. And my opponent's going to reboot, so I will be pausing. Alright, opponent kept 6, which presumably not as good as the 7. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with this draw. I mean, the Return Centaur is probably going to do what it's supposed to do here, and casting Balefly Dawn seems pretty good. Even without the fact that I would have to discard off Read the Bones, just having a 2-drop when I have a 3, a 4, and multiple 5s. So, well, it seems like it's worth casting. Of course, I do need to draw a land here. Well, of course, that also gives me a little incentive. Could just miss on lands. I mean, that'd be a sweet way to end the draft. Jeez. That's a good start. Well, I'm glad I've got the Balefly Dawn, though. My opponent, ooh, and I hit the land. My opponent does have a spell, then that an instant that does stop Balefly Dawn, since favorite hoplite prevents everything. Alright, and draws a card. Jeez. Alright. This is a pretty sick start. Turn not a normal curve of favorite hoplite into Scourge Mark into Chronicler of Heroes, or Muldrifter, if you will. Alright. I guess I'll be reading some bones. Yeah, let's just keep these. My hand's good enough that I don't think I want to mess around by like putting a land on the bottom. I would be tempted to if my hand was a little less good, but it is pretty strong. There are a lot of things here that mess me up, though. That is one of them. Alright. And you're attacking? Alright, well, I'm snap blocking since I'm not really going to have the option later. Alright, let's play Insatiable Harpy since if I'm not getting to block anyway, I might as well gain some life on the attack back. So I'm taking 6 here, going to 9. Then I get to play Grey Merchant, drain for 4, attack for 2. Alright, so we're getting pressure pretty hard. This is a sick 1, 2, 3, 4 curve on my opponent's part. I actually probably wish my opponent had kept the first hand. And an Asp? Jeez. Alright, well, I've got to start playing Grey Merchants like my life depends on it, because it does. I actually don't think it's possible that my opponent's 7-card hand could have been better than this. I mean, you never know. Alright, so Grey Merchant gets tapped here. And I guess I take 10. Alright, well, I'm taking 10. One turn without a play? That would be nice. Since next turn... no, a Reaper of the Wild. And if another favorite hot play. Yeah, this is... this is pretty realistic. I'm in trouble here, I would say. I mean, I have a second Grey Merchant, which is nice. I guess I could have attacked with Insatiable Harpy, but it keeps back the Hoplite. Makes heal at emissary. Alright. Message I can read at some point, I'm sure. So what's getting in here? I mean, obviously they're all attacking, but... what's my plan? So what gets tapped now? Alright, so I'm at 9. So what can I do? Not a whole lot, as it turns out. I suppose I've got to chump something. So I can't double block the Heliod's Emissary, because that's really what I want to do. I suppose I have to chump that, and then I just block the Heliod's Emissary, and I take 8. Alright. I don't think I can win this game. I mean, obviously my opponent's going to have Boon of Erebos just to kill me, but even if they didn't... this is going to be a tough one to win. I've got Farrakha's Cure. And my opponent kept the card on top. Alright. Jeez, another giant thing? A Sentry of the Underworld. Well, this is the least close game I've ever played in my entire life. Yeah, I'm like super dead here. I can I can attach this, I can cast a Ferica's Cure, so I can go up to 3, then attach this and attack for 4, go up to like 7, then take like a million damage. This is, like I said, the best, this is the best draw I've ever seen, not even close.